got some big-ass snowflakes falling.
Well, this is our first snow of the year. The weather's changing quite quickly. We've only got two more builds left. We've got this one and another one. But we're just getting a little bit of snow. Nothing to frantic over.
Look at this, baby.
I know.
Stick your tongue out.
Here he is, Mr. Tattoo in Veronica Lake.
Morning.
Morning.
How you doing?
I'm about even, I guess.
Beautiful morning for it. Hey,
hi.
Hello. Nice to meet you. I remember you.
Did you order this?
Yeah.
No?
No, not really.
We're not ready for it.
Not really.
The snow's here. We definitely didn't beat the snow, so we just have to get it done before it's up to here, because that will happen, and it's on its way.
Ah, look at that now, would you?
Ooh.
When I walk in Chris's shop, I see a lot of history. So am I allowed to just look around?
You wouldn't be in here if I didn't want you to look around. What's the point in coming?
You can never judge a book by its cover, but you can judge a man by his garage. When did you start? When you was a young man, or did your father show you?
I got the disease about the age of 7.
The disease?
Yeah.
Is that what we're calling it, a disease? Because I got it.
It is a disease. Of course you have it.
Oh.
You wouldn't be here if you didn't. Being a motorhead is a disease. The symptoms of the disease: dirty fingernails, staying out in the shop all night, working on something that most people wouldn't give you 5 cents for. The whole thing is just some kind of madness. It's just something that happened to me. It's like measles. You get it or you don't. I want you to consider building me an open wheel racer.
Okay, cool.
When the big names like Buick and Chevrolet were racing at, say, Indianapolis or whatever, there's no two of those cars that are really the same. Buick would have its name on it, but they'd have somebody like you build it.
How much money are you looking to spend?
About 10 grand.
So we're gonna make it from whatever we can.
Yeah.
We're gonna build you a race car you've never seen before.
I can imagine.
I wanna thank you very much.
Okay.
And I will not disappoint you, I hope.
I'm easily content with the best of everything.
Did you hear that, baby? Easily content with the best of everything. I have to remember that.
It took forever for me to find these parts, but the clutch and pressure plate are finally here. You know the saying, it's rare as hen's teeth. Well, we found the hen that has teeth. Man, I tell you, I was skeptical at first.
As soon as Alex gets the transmission in, I can finish fabrication.
What a hard find that was to get.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Geez, that's precious gold right there.
Geez, you're excited.
Oh, my God.
And now is the day that we hook it. I mean, still we got a radius in there, we got a body almost built. Now we got to work in a knot hole. Yeah. But that's what happens sometimes when you can't get parts, I guess, is it not?
It's exactly right.
We cannot stop moving forward because we haven't got something. We got to keep moving forward. Mm. It's just that we have to work a little harder sometimes.
The clutch is still really good,
that's
too.
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's got lots of... That's awesome.
You have no idea.
So... You just got to clean that up a little bit and slide that
bad boy
in.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll get the car sort of lifted up for you.
That is awesome.
Oh, good. My heart just sunk for a
that
second.
That is awesome. It's the exact same.
So. Awesome. So the starter's working everything?
Yes.
Yes.
That's the only other thing that was on. I got the transmission assembled. Now we just have to get it in place.
I can see right where the teeth are going. That's where we want to go, like right there. Go up a little tiny bit.
Feel good, real good.
A little more.
Now, just push straight. Okay, whoa. It's gonna fall off the back. My dick. Push down on the back of the trailer. Whoa, too much. I know it'll fit, because I had the thing in there.
You want a hand, do you?
Not jiving.
Can you put grease on that at all?
No, you don't put grease on the clutch.
Yeah.
It should go in. There it goes. Yeah, whoa.
Okay.
It means something to me to have that engine, that transmission all hooked up again, ready to rock and roll. That hasn't been hooked up in 30 years. Now she's gonna run a race car. Those who look towards the past move on the future a lot faster. You understand that?
Yeah.
Well, what am I saying?
You know, say it again.
Windshield's going in.
Yay! All right. That's cool. We have done nothing to this car that couldn't have not been done in the day. Well, this is gonna work or fit or what, but we're gonna try it. Dinner! It does look like a seat that would have been done that. It's worn and tattered and turdy.
It's all hands on deck right now. I'm trying to get a lot done in a short amount of time. I'm getting used to getting my hands dirty, I guess. Just like one of the boys. Building cars.
I built a muffler box because I knew we had to have an exhaust system on it. The exhaust is on. I'm just got a little bit of anxiety. I want to start, right? Everything's hooked up, steering's hooked up, brakes are hooked up. I'd like to see it start, wouldn't you? I wonder how I'm gonna hear it start. Come on, baby. That's honky tonking.
That's loud. That thing's way louder than the first time you started.
That's true. Race car. That's what you hear race day.
Yeah.
Damn, that looks good.
We're at the airport. We're going to reveal a race car that the team has built for Chris. And I just can't wait for him to see it. You know, I think he's going to really take him back, and I think he's going to really enjoy it.
I don't know what he's come up with. I wouldn't be here if I wasn't very curious. And we'll see what he's done.
What you think, Chris? Fastest man in the world in 1942.
Listen, man, that's something else.
I'm glad you think
that's
so.
That's something right out of Mad Max.
Right on, awesome. Oh, man. Glad you like it.
Oh, I love it. Well, I'm at a loss for words. I think it's great. I wouldn't do anything to it. The workmanship in it's great. It is what it really would have looked like back when they were building such things, and they did build them. It's, I think, a real work of art. There's no fanciness or fake to it. It's just as real as it can be, which to me makes it really attractive.
We've got a V12 yeah. Pierce Aero.
Good God.
24 spark plug. And yeah. That thing was sitting for 20 years, and this man tore it apart.
My God, what an engine. What's that engine weigh, 900 pounds?
1,500.
Whoa. Well, I love the engine. You just don't see that sort of thing outside of a museum. When people like me are gone, that engine will still be a part of history. And if you're gonna preserve it, why not put it in something that you're gonna really look at? It's like, what in the hell is that? Well, there it is.